एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आवर सीरीज बूस्ट योर बेसिक्स। आज हम फार्मास्यूटिकल इनकॉम्पेटिबिलिटीज के बारे में पढ़ेंगे, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। इनकॉम्पेटिबिलिटीज, ओके, सो व्हाट इज इनकॉम्पेटिबिलिटीज? व्हेनेवर टू सब्सटेंसेस और टू इंग्रेडिएंट्स आर नॉट कॉम्पेटिबल विद ईच अदर, दैट टाइम इट विल गिव राइज टू इनकॉम्पेटिबिलिटीज। इट कैन बी बिटवीन टू ड्रग्स और इट कैन बी बिटवीन अ ड्रग एंड एन एक्सिपिएंट्स। ओके, सो दीज थिंग्स विल सी इन डिटेल टूडे। So, what is incompatibilities? Okay, why it arises? It arises due to the result of prescribing or mixing two or more substances which are antagonist in nature, an undesirable product is formed. Okay, but due to these incompatibilities, we are getting an undesirable product in most of the cases. Okay, which may affect the safety, purpose, and the appearance of the preparation, and even the efficacy and therapeutic action of the drugs may get altered. Okay, and it is usually unintentional. There are basically three types: physical, chemical, and therapeutic. Okay, so in olden days, the pharmacist which was there, okay, he used to prepare one particular formulation in his pharmacy or in his chemist shop only. Okay, that time doctor used to prescribe, okay, all the ingredients he used to write along with its quantity, okay, of particular formulation, and the pharmacist used to compound this particular formulation in his pharmacy or in his chemist shop only. Okay, and that time the pharmacist used to notice such kind of incompatibilities like physical and chemical. But nowadays, since all the pharmaceutical formulations are available in the ready-made form, okay, through our pharmaceutical industries, okay, so nowadays this compounding step is hardly seen, right? This is very rare. And because of that, the pharmacist hardly notices such incompatibilities in his chemist shop or in pharmacy. Okay, but this kind of therapeutic incompatibility the pharmacist can notice and can rectify. Okay, for example, if doctor prescribes, okay, higher dose unintentionally, if doctor prescribes higher amount of dose, okay, for the pediatric class of patient, okay, so that time the pharmacist can tell the doctor about but this particular incompatibility. Okay, and one more thing can happen, like agar ek patient hai, okay, wo us pharmacy ka ek regular customer hai, okay, so the pharmacist know about his or her medical history, right? If for example ek patient hai, okay, वो ट्यूबरकुलोसिस से सफर हो रही है, एक लेडी पेशेंट है, ओके, शी इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम ट्यूबरकुलोसिस एंड शी इज टेकिंग द ड्रग रिफामपिसिन, ओके, एंड शी आस्क्ड फॉर ओरल कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव्स, ओके, सो दैट टाइम द इट इज द ड्यूटी ऑफ फार्मासिस्ट टू टेल दैट दिस ओरल कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव थेरेपी माइट फेल. व्हाई? बिकॉज शी इज टेकिंग रिफामपिसिन एंड रिफामपिसिन इज एंजाइम इंड्यूसर, राइट? सो इट विल इंक्रीज द मेटाबोलिज्म ऑफ ओरल कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव एंड दैट्स व्हाई इट मे लीड टू फेलियर ऑफ दिस ओरल कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव. ओके, सो दैट टाइम इट इज द ड्यूटी ऑफ फार्मासिस्ट टू टेल, ओके, अबाउट सच इनकॉम्पेटिबिलिटीज टू द पेशेंट और टू द डॉक्टर. ओके, सो नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद फिजिकल इनकॉम्पेटिबिलिटी. So under physical incompatibility, we are having different incompatibilities such as immiscibility, insolubility, precipitation, liquefaction. Okay, so we'll see each one in detail. So whenever two or more substances, okay, are combined together, a physical change takes place. Okay, and this physical change is visible, and an unacceptable product is formed. Okay, सबसे पहला वाला है immiscibility. Okay, this is a type of physical incompatibility. Immiscibility यानी क्या? Any two liquids, okay, they are immiscible with each other. Like in this case, oils and water, they are immiscible with each other, right? So to make them miscible, okay, we are using some kind of agent like emulsifying agent. Okay, हम emulsifying agent use करते हैं, okay, through emulsification process. Okay, through this emulsification process, we are making these two immiscible liquids miscible ones, right? So यहाँ पर एक example है emulsion of castor oil and water. Okay, so remedy क्या है? Make a emulsion with a suitable emulsifying agent. By using suitable emulsifying agent, we can rectify or we can avoid this kind of incompatibility. Okay, next one is insolubility. ओके सो इनसेलिबिलिटी मतलब कुछ जो ड्रग्स है लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल इन दिस केस सल्फामेथोक्साजोल फिनाएसिटिन जिंक ऑक्साइड ओके दे आर इनडिफ्यूजिबल और इनसेल्युबल इन पर्टिकुलर सॉल्वेंट ओके और जब वो इनडिफ्यूजिबल होंगे तब वो हमें जो हम डोज लेंगे ओके दैट विल नॉट गिव अस एक्यूरेट measurement of dose right because it is indiffusible in that particular solvent okay so in order to facilitate accurate measurement of the dose we are making use of suspending agent okay so yahan par ek example liya hai humne sulfamethoxazole and primethoprim are indiffusible in water and hence we are using sodium CMC that is sodium carboxymethyl cellulose is a suspending agent over here okay so which is making this sulfamethoxazole and primethoprim diffusible okay in water so that it will facilitate the accurate measurement of the dose okay so remedy is make use of suitable suspending agent to ye jo suspending agent hoga wo kya karega either it will increase the thickness of the preparation or it will make this indiffusible solids diffusible ones okay then next one we are having is precipitation okay so solubilized substances may precipitate whenever they are added in the solvent okay which is non solvent meaning it is not dissolving or it is not soluble in that particular solvent okay so non solvent for the substance is added to the solution okay for example over here alcohol solution of resins okay agar alcohol solution of resins hai okay and we know that resins are insoluble in water okay so for resins water is a non solvent for it okay aur agar humne ye isme add kiya water agar humne isme add kiya to hame precipitated resins milenge okay so this is kind of a incompatibility then next example is lotion of compound tincture of benzoin okay so remedy hai addition of tincture with rapid stirring yields a fine colloidal dispersion okay agar humne tincture jo hai wo agar rapid stir karke add kiya to hame fine colloidal dispersion milega hame precipitate nahi milega okay nahi milega so this colloidal dispersion is very fine okay it is around 0.1 nanometer to 0.1 micrometers okay so precipitate will not form over here then next one is liquefaction so some low melting point solids sometimes liquefy when mixed together due to the formation of eutectic mixture or liberation of water okay for example yahan par hai menthol thymol camphor okay agar wo humne separately diya to kuch bhi nahi hoga like they will be in its state only like in solid state only but whenever they are given together okay they will melt and they will form an homogeneous liquid okay so because of that that will give rise to liquefaction incompatibility okay so what is remedy for that the eutectic forming ingredient okay may either be dispensed separately or these may be mixed separately with enough quantity of adsorbent like magnesium carbonate or kaolin to form a free flowing powder okay two things we can do over here either we can dispense them separately या फिर हम जो एडसॉर्बेंट्स है लाइक मैग्नीशियम कार्बोनेट और या फिर केओलिन ओके इसका यूज करके हम एक फ्री फ्लोइंग प्रोडक्ट बना सकते हैं ओके देन नेक्स्ट वन इज केमिकल इनकॉम्पेटिबिलिटीज ओके सो इन केमिकल इनकॉम्पेटिबिलिटीज दिस में अराइज ड्यू टू द केमिकल इंटरेक्शन बिटवीन द इनग्रीडियंट्स ओके सो दिस में ऑकर ड्यू टू द ऑक्सीडेशन रिडक्शन और एसिड बेस हाइड्रोलाइसिस और कॉम्बिनेशन रिएक्शन ओके और ये हमें कैसे नोटिस होगा लाइक कलर चेंज विल टेक प्लेस या फिर एक्सप्लोजन होगा या फिर डीकंपोजिशन एफर्वेसेंस प्रेसिपिटेशन ओके दिस थिंग्स विल नोटिस नाउ देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ केमिकल इनकॉम्पेटिबिलिटीज ओके टॉलरेटेड एंड एडजस्टेड अगर हमें ये टॉलरेटेड इनकॉम्पेटिबिलिटीज कम करना है या मिनिमाइज करना है देन व्हाट वी आर चेंजिंग द ऑर्डर ऑफ मिक्सिंग और मिक्सिंग द सोल्यूशन इन dilute form okay but there is no change in the active ingredient of the preparation okay ye yaad rakhna in adjusted ones kya hoga we are preventing this type of incompatibilities by addition or substitution of one of the reacting substances with another of equal therapeutic value okay yahan par hum order of mixing change karenge ya fir mixing the solution in dilute form इन टॉलरेटेड वन एंड इन एडजस्टेड वन हम क्या करेंगे यहाँ पर हम एडिशन और सब्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ any of the reacting substances with other with of equal therapeutic value. Okay. Then we are having one example over here, alkaloidal incompatibilities. Okay. So whenever due to incompatibilities, the precipitate is forming. Okay. That time the precipitate can be two types, diffusible and indiffusible. Okay. So whenever the precipitate formed is diffusible, that time we are using method A. Okay. And whenever the precipitate which is there, okay, if it is indiffusible, that time we are using method B, okay, to dispense. So in method A, what we are doing while compounding that particular preparation, okay, we are taking the vehicle, we are dividing that vehicle into two halves, okay. So in one part we are adding that particular reacting ingredient, in second part or in second half we are adding another ingredient, okay, which is reacting, okay. So and afterwards we are adding one part to the other part. Okay, so this is method A. Okay, whichever preparations are giving the diffusible kind of precipitates, okay, they are formulated using the method A. Okay, or they are dispensed or they are compounded by using the method A. And whenever the indiffusible precipitates are formed by the particular preparation, that time how we are compounding it, we are taking the vehicle, we are dividing it into two halves. Okay, in one part we are adding that ingredient, one reacting ingredient. In second half we are adding the compound ragakant, okay, and we are preparing a mucilage. Okay, compound ragakant is acting as a suspending agent, right? And then we are adding the remaining ingredients in this. Okay, and then this part is added to this part, okay, with rapid stirring. So this is method B. Okay, so this is for method A is for diffusible ones, method B is for indiffusible precipitates. Okay, this is how we can compound this kind of preparations. Okay, in this case yahan par example hai alkaloidal salts with alkaline substances ka. Okay, we know that jo alkaloidal salts hai, okay, they are soluble in water, but jo simply free alkaloids hai, they are not soluble in water, right? So strychnine hydrochloride, which is there, okay, it is an alkaloid salt. And aromatic spirit of ammonia is there, okay, which is an alkaline substance. Okay, so whenever they are combined together, okay, the insoluble strychnine is precipitated out. Okay, ये जो strychnine है, simply strychnine है, वो insoluble होता है water में. लेकिन जो strychnine hydrochloride है, that is soluble in water. Okay, but whenever this alkaline substances like ammonia and this strychnine hydrochloride alkaloidal salt which is there, they are combined together, they will precipitate this insoluble strychnine. Okay, and remedy kya hai yahan par, strychnine hydrochloride solution should be dissolved in half the required quantity of water. Okay, and while the aromatic spirit of ammonia should be dissolved in the remaining portion of the water. Okay, the two portions should be mixed slowly. Okay, so yahan par jo hame precipitate form hota hai in this preparation is diffusible PPT. Okay, we are getting diffusible, hence you can see here we are using method A over here, right? Hum quantity lete, matlab hum water lete, water yahan par as a vehicle act karega, right? So hum water lenge, usko half equal halves mein divide karenge, ek half mein hum strychnine hydrochloride dalenge aur dusre half mein hum aromatic spirit of ammonia dalenge. Okay, and that's how we are getting this particular preparation. Okay, and these two portions should be mixed slowly. Okay, and that's why we are get since we are getting here diffusible PPT, we are using method A over here. Okay, for the preparation. Now let's see some other examples. Alkaloidal salts with soluble iodides, then alkaloidal salts with tannins, then alkaloidal salts with salicylates, alkaloidal salts with soluble iodides and bromides. Okay, so these are other examples. Then soluble salicylates incompatibilities में आते हैं soluble salicylates with ferric salts, soluble salicylates with alkali carbonates, soluble salicylates with benzoates with acids. Okay, then soluble iodides incompatibilities में आते हैं oxidation of iodides with ferric salts, then oxidation of iodides with potassium chlorate and oxidation of iodides with quinine sulfate. Okay, these are few other examples. Then next one is chemical incompatibilities causing evolution of carbon dioxide gas. Okay, gas formation may be evolved due to the chemical reaction between the ingredients of the formulation. Okay, yahan par carbon dioxide evolve hoga. okay, and this kind of preparations which are there, okay, they are first prepared in an open vessel, okay, and when this carbon dioxide gas ceases, okay, the effervescence, whenever this effervescence are ceases, that time after effervescence ceases, that time it is added into the dispensing bottle and then they are marketed or then they are dispensed, okay. But before that, it is first has to prepare in open vessel, okay, in order to avoid bursting of the bottle, okay. And here the examples are sodium bicarbonate with soluble calcium and magnesium salts, then bismuth subnitrate and sodium bicarbonate, then borax with sodium bicarbonate and glycerin, okay. So these are the examples where there is a evolution of carbon dioxide gases there. Then next, ionic reactions, okay. So yeah, but the therapeutic or the pharmaceutical properties of many organic compounds are usually associated with large cation or anion. Okay. So ek example hai ki jab creams, okay, whenever the creams contain cationic emulsions, okay, they are made using cationic emulsions, that particular emulsion will crack, okay, if we mix with a cream prepared using an anionic emulsions. Okay. And then another example, anionic solubilizers may lower the antimicrobial activity of cationic medicament or preservative. Okay. Next is explosive combinations. So oxidizing agents chemically incompatible hote hai, okay, with reducing agents, and a combination of the two in a formulation may lead to explosive reactions. Okay. So example over here is potassium chlorate with oxidizable substances like sulfur, tannic acid, etc. Okay, then last one we are having over here is color changes. Okay, so the color changes may be due to the changes in pH, and how we can rectify this by using a specific buffering solution. Okay, we can rectify this particular incompatibility. Now let's move on to the next part, that is therapeutic incompatibility. Okay, so first one is error in dosage. Many therapeutic incompatibilities arise from errors in writing, okay, by the prescriber, or interpreting, okay, that is by the pharmacist, the prescription order. First one is overdose, okay. So yahan par hum dekh sakte ki jo codeine phosphate hai, okay, it is written over here 0.5 grams. The intention of the physician may be to prescribe only 5 mg, but at he prescribed 500 mg unintentionally, okay. So that time this prescription should be referred back to the prescriber. Okay, next hai wrong dose or dosage form. Okay, some drugs like quite similar names they have, like prednisolone and prednisone, digitoxin and decoxin. Okay, so that time the confusion may arise, which may give rise to the incompatibilities. Okay, hence it becomes necessary to seek the clarification from the prescriber. Okay, and sometimes dosage form, matlab ek hi drug bahut sare dosage forms mein, jaise ki tablets, capsules, emulsions, suspensions, bahut sare dosage forms mein available hota hai, right? So which particular dosage form is written by the doctor on the prescription? Okay, if doctor has not mentioned that particular dosage form, so that time the pharmacist should ask the doctor. Okay, this doubt should get clarified. Okay, hence this becomes necessary to seek clarification from the prescriber. Okay, then next one is contraindicated drugs. Okay, so certain drugs which may be contraindicated in particular disease or in a particular patient who is allergic to it. Okay, so for example yahan par hai jo corticosteroids hote hain, okay, they are contraindicated in patients having active peptic ulcer. Okay, aisa kyun hai? Kyunki jo corticosteroids hai, they either aggravate, okay, they aggravate these peptic ulcers by increasing the acid secretion and by decreasing the bicarbonate or mucus production. Okay, and jo next example hai wo hai penicillin and sulfa drugs. Okay, they are contraindicated to the patients who are allergic to it. Okay, the next one is synergistic and antagonistic drugs. Synergism yani kya, when two drugs are prescribed together, they tend to increase the activity of each other. This is usually intentional. Example hai aspirin and paracetamol increases the analgesic activity. Then next one is antagonism. When one drug decreases or abolishes the action of another, they are said to be antagonistic. Okay, yahan par example hai the reduction of anticoagulant action of warfarin when an agent that accelerates its hepatic metabolism is such as phenobarbital is used. Okay, जो phenobarbital है is an enzyme inducer, right? So that time this warfarin will undergo metabolism at a higher rate. Okay, and that's why its anticoagulant action will get reduced. Then next are drug interactions. Okay, so the effect of one drug is altered by the prior or the simultaneous administration of another drug. Okay, and there can be drug-drug interaction or there can be drug-food interaction also. The drug adjustment of dosage is if the suspected interaction is detected. Okay, so यहाँ पर दिया है tetracycline hydrochloride and direction में दिया है कि to take one capsule every 6 hours with milk. Okay, so as we know that tetracycline is inactivated by calcium ions present in the milk, right? So it should not be taken with milk. Okay, and in this prescription, the therapeutic incompatibility is unintentional, right? So the prescription is referred back to the prescriber to change the direction. Okay, so these are the kind of therapeutic incompatibilities. So now we have few more questions to solve, but before that, if you want more such videos, do subscribe to our channel, Dharmesh Mehta GPET. You can press the bell icon and you will be notified every time a video is posted. We also have a free WhatsApp group, okay, where we post daily 5 MCQs. So if you want to get added on that group or if you want to join our classes, you can just contact on these numbers. You can mention your name, your college name, and we'll do the needful. So now let's move on to the questions. Liquefaction is the example of dash incompatibility. Okay, so physical incompatibility, chemical incompatibility, therapeutic incompatibility, yeah, phir none of the above. Okay, so what is liquefaction? Some low melting point solids, okay, humne examples dekhe the, jaise ki camphor tha, menthol tha, right, which liquefy when mixed together. Jab wo mix hote hai, they will liquefy and will form a eutectic mixture due to the formation of eutectic mixture or liberation of water. Okay, aur ye humne kahan par dekha tha, immiscibility, insolubility, precipitation, liquefaction, humne kahan par dekha tha, physical incompatibilities mein, right? So answer is physical incompatibility. Next question, strategy to correct the eutectic mixture formation is, okay, dispense ingredients separately या फिर mix ingredients separately with suitable adsorbents like kaolin and finally mix together, both A and B, none of the above. Okay, so सबसे पहले देखते हैं कि eutectic system क्या होती है या eutectic mixture क्या होता है. Eutectic system is a system of homogeneous mixture of substances that either melts, okay, or solidifies at a particular given temperature that is lower than the melting point of any of the mixture of any of the constituent elements. Okay, जो separately अगर हमने दो, एक menthol है, camphor है, okay, वो separate जब होते हैं तब वो in the solid state होते हैं, लेकिन वो जब हम एक साथ देते हैं, okay, तब वो melt होकर एक होमोजेनियस मिक्सचर फॉर्म करते हैं जिसको हम यूटेक्टिक मिक्सचर बोलते हैं. ओके, एंड व्हेनेवर दे आर कंबाइंड टुगेदर देयर मेल्टिंग पॉइंट बिकम्स और देयर मेल्टिंग पॉइंट डिक्रीजेस. ओके, देन देयर इंडिविजुअल मेल्टिंग पॉइंट. ओके, सो दिस इज अ यूटेक्टिक मिक्सचर. तो ये हमने देखा था, राइट? वी हैव टू मेथड्स ओवर हियर, दैट इज आइदर वी कैन डिस्पेंस इट सेपरेटली और वी कैन एड द एडसॉर्बेंट्स लाइक केओलिन और मैग्नीशियम कार्बोनेट, राइट? सो द करेक्ट आंसर विल बी बोथ ए एंड बी. Then next one is, which of the following incompatibility will happen in the following case? Sulfadiazine, sulfamerazine, okay, 250 mg 250 mg, and ammonium chloride 500 mg. Okay, so options are therapeutic incompatibility, chemical incompatibility, physical incompatibility, and none of the above. Okay, so this ammonium chloride which is there, okay, it is a urinary acidifier. It would cause deposition of sulfonamide in crystal form in the kidney. Okay, so this kind of thing which is there, it is, that's why this ammonium chloride is contraindicated with sulfonamides. Okay, and that's why this is therapeutic kind of incompatibility. Okay, they are contraindicated with each other, so that's why the correct answer will be therapeutic incompatibility. Then next one, chemical incompatibility in which the chemical interaction can be minimized by changing the order of mixing is, okay, ye bhi humne dekha tha, right? First option is tolerated, then adjusted, then immediate, and then delayed. Okay, so tolerated yani kya, These reactions can be minimized by applying some suitable changes in order of mixing or mixing the solution in dilute form. Okay, but there is no change in the active ingredient of the preparation. Okay, so the correct answer over here will be tolerated. Okay, in adjusted, what we are doing? We are just changing the particular reacting substances with another of equal therapeutic value, right? So in this question, the correct answer will be tolerated. Then next question, what will happen when you triturate an oxidizing substances like potassium chloride with an oxidizable substances like sulfur? Okay. So correct, the options are liquefaction, precipitate, explosion, and eutectic mixture. Aur ye bhi humne dekha tha, right? So the correct answer over here is explosion. We have seen this example under explosion kind of chemical incompatibility. Then next one, which one of the following will happen during the compounding of this prescription? Sodium bicarbonate 1.5 gram, borax 1.5 gram, phenol 0.75 grams and glycerin 25 ml and water up to 100 ml. Options are effervescence of carbon dioxide, precipitate formation of sodium borate, precipitate formation of bromophenol, and there is no incompatibility. So we'll see some solution when sodium bicarbonate, borax and glycerin, okay, these three ingredients which are there, okay, whenever they are mixed together in the presence of water, okay, in the presence of water, what will happen? They will give rise to the evolution of the carbon dioxide. Okay. If the mixture is dispensed as such, there are chances of bursting the bottle. Okay. Ye humne discuss kiya tha, right? Under this evolution of carbon dioxide part. Therefore, mix these ingredients in open vessel until the evolution of carbon dioxide ceases. Okay. And then add phenol and transfer the mixture to the bottle. Okay. So this is the solution for this question. So correct option over here will be, it will give rise to effervescence of carbon dioxide, right? So the correct option is A. Yes. So that's it for today. Thank you. All the best for your exams.